Hey, what's up, everybody? This is Charles. I want to welcome you guys to another episode of Dreamers Pro Show, where we cover everything from sports, hot topics, classic debates, and where we give you a fresh perspective on things and how we see them. And in today's episode, man, I'm going to have some fun with this episode. I'm going to piss a lot of people off, but I don't give a damn. So the topic today is why Serge Ibaka is one of the final championship pieces for the Clippers. So that's the topic I want to get into in today's video. But before we get into that, I want you guys to please make sure you go ahead and hit the like button, hit the subscribe button, and hit the notification bell to be notified whenever we drop our content. And also be sure to check out our Dreamers Pro podcast, which is linked in the description below. So let's just get into the topic here. So yesterday, man, a lot of people, we did a video that we're going to link in the end of this video here. We did a video talking about the snakes in the grass with how Montrezl Harrell betrayed the Clippers to go play with the Lakers. And man, that video was the most polarizing video we've probably ever done. Has so many dislikes, so many people coming out of the woodworks saying that I was hurt and I'm the black Skip Bayless and you're crying and all of this different stuff. And people were, I'm sure it was all Lakers fans or and just general haters. And even some people subscribed to the channel. Hey, listen, if you're subscribed to the channel to disagree with me, that's fine. I appreciate you taking the time to even watch these videos and comment on it. So that's your goal, no problem. You know, you don't have to agree with me. If you just maybe you just enjoy the content, you just like to disagree with me, which is fine. So no problem with that. So that's also expected. So we had a lot of pushback on that video yesterday and what we said. And guess what? I know I'm sure I probably upset a lot of people. And guess what? I'm gonna double down today. So listen, I'm trying to hold my laughing because y'all had a lot to say yesterday. Y'all had so much to say in these comment sections. So now it's my turn on the behalf of all the Clipper fans out there who are laughing their you know what off last night and are probably still laughing now after they heard the news. So I'm gonna laugh for you guys in public. Ha! I'm gonna laugh for you guys. So listen, turns out that the Clippers were able to sign Serge Ibaka. Yes, they were able to get Serge Ibaka. Ibaka. They were able to sign him yesterday. So as I said before, we knew that one of the major weak points for the Clippers, and to be fair to Nick Wright, he pointed this out, that listen, the Clippers do not have enough size to contend with the Lakers. That was the major pain points for the Clippers last season. We saw that when they went up against the Denver Nuggets, although I still think they were good enough to beat them because they got up 3-1 on the team, but it would have certainly helped to have a big 7-footer that could play defense, hit open shots, and block shots and play one man-on-man defense on any big in the NBA. And they didn't have that. Ivica Zubac is talented, but he doesn't have enough size on his body. And he's not really known as a defensive specialist, although he can play defense and block shots, but not at the level of Serge Ibaka. Montrezl Harrell, the snake in the grass who decided to go play with the Lakers, he plays with a lot of intensity, but his playoff production went out of the window. I don't know where. Oh, it probably went to the Lakers stadium. That's where it went. He was probably saving it for the Lakers. That's what happened. Maybe Clutch Sports called him up and say, hey, listen, man. Yo, Montrezl, listen, man. Throw it in the bucket. His mentor, LeBron, was probably texting him before those games. Like, you know what to do, man. You know what you got to do because we're going to get you next season. Now, some of you people may be tight for me saying that, but look, hey, but guess what? It looks awfully suspicious, man, that your mentor is your direct competitor and that's the dude you go sign with. So, hey, listen, John Michael Green left. At least he went to the Denver Nuggets, man. Yeah, they beat them, but he ain't going to the Lakers. So that's probably what was happening in the background. But as I said, who cares? Because we got Serge Ibaka. So we knew that that was one of their pain points that they had last season. And obviously, they still need a traditional point guard, although I think they're going to make some moves to solidify that final pain point on the team. Now, who is Serge Ibaka? Serge Ibaka, last season for the Toronto Raptors, Serge Ibaka, let me look at his numbers. So he averaged 15.4 points per game, got you 8.2 rebounds and 1.4 assists. Now, if we look at his playoff numbers here, if I can pull them up last season, he averaged 14.8 points a game. He shot 57% from the field. He shot 51% from the three as a center in the NBA. So y'all go figure that. He shot 100% from the free throw line. He got you 7.2 rebounds and 1.2 assists and 1.3 blocks. Now, let me just ask you guys out there. Isn't this dude better than... Wouldn't you rather have Serge Ibaka than Montrezl Harrell? Is it even a comparison? Is it really even a comparison? the Montrezl Harrell that has great regular seasons, and when it gets to the playoffs, the guy goes off to go see Mickey Mouse, or is probably in his room texting with LeBron James and Clutch Sports. That Montrezl Harrell, no, I don't think. I think the Clippers actually got better. It's called addition by subtraction, but in this case, they got somebody they can actually depend on, not Montrezl Harrell, who was sitting there probably texting with LeBron James in his pajamas, trying to plan out their next move in the offseason. So I got a lot to say about that, but I just think that was a dirty move and a grimy move, and I'm not gonna come up off that. So that's what I feel. If some of you people disagree with me, that's your business. You don't have to watch the video, you can watch something else or dislike the video. But anyway, that's what Serge Ibaka brings. Now, you remember at the end of the playoffs when the Clippers lost, Kawhi Leonard said we need some high IQ basketball players. Guess what, guys? Serge Ibaka is an NBA champion. If you look at the Toronto Raptors run that they had to the NBA Finals 2 years ago, he was one of the most pivotal pieces in that entire run. He came up so big for that team time and time again all throughout the run, including the finals, that really helped them capture that championship ring. So Serge Ibaka was an integral part. He has a high basketball IQ. He already knows how to win, so he's bringing championship experience to the team. And now the Clippers can at least say they have two players that have championship experience. Kawhi Leonard could look down the court and look at somebody that he's been in the trenches with and say, hey, listen, okay, I know I have someone on this floor that can help me with these guys, because, hey, listen, this guy's already been there. I know somebody that's going to be able to embrace the moment, but also the impact he's going to have on his other teammates, because Serge Ibaka seems to be a vocal leader. He talks, he gets in guys' ears, he can sort of galvanize guys, get the guys on the right page. So I think, apart from what he brings on the floor, I think his leadership, his experience, all of these things that you have to count for. And if we're going to talk about Montrezl Harrell, we can't even compare those two things, because Montrezl Harrell doesn't have any of those qualities. I liked him as a player, but again, as I said, that move left a dirty taste in my mouth. And for me, I think he is the prototypical big that the Clippers needed to be able to make that final push for their championship aspirations. Simply, that's what I think. I mean, I truly believe that. He has size. If I look at him here, how tall is Serge Ibaka? Serge Ibaka is a legitimate 7-footer, man, 230 pounds. Now, he's 31 years old, but he's not old, but he's still... I don't see Serge Ibaka playing 30-plus minutes a game or 40 minutes a game, so I'm sure they're going to manage his minutes properly. Last season, he played 23 minutes a game. They'll probably have him somewhere around that this season, so he's going to play great minutes. I think Tyronn Lue is going to have a lot of options on the court closing out games. They no longer have to worry about Montrez trying to pick up bigger players. It's not going to happen again. If the Clippers want to go to a tall lineup, they can go with Ivica Zubac, Serge Ibaka, then they can go with Kawhi Leonard, the power forward, and Paul George is a small forward at the shooting guard. You already have four players on the court that are over 6'7", 6'8", and two players that are basically 7 foot tall. So size is no longer going to be an issue. I think they still have to make one final move to get a point guard, but I think Serge Ibaka is a major championship piece and probably the best big that they could possibly have gone out there, because originally I was saying that I was lobbying for them to get Robin Lopez, but Robin Lopez doesn't have that championship experience, although he can do similar things to Serge Ibaka by spacing the floor, hitting threes. But Serge Ibaka, man, I think he is the perfect fit for them, and I think he's one of the final championship pieces that the Clippers need to be able to solidify their championship hopes this season. So what I want to know from you guys is quite simple. Do you agree with me? Do you think that Serge Ibaka is one of the final championship pieces? Or do you think not? Or are you still waiting for them to get another point guard? Whatever you guys think, please leave your thoughts and comments in the comment section below. Again, if you enjoyed the video, please make sure you go ahead and hit the like button, hit the subscribe button, hit the notification bell to be notified whenever we drop our content. Once again, this is Charles here from Dreamers Pro. Wishing you guys an amazing day, and catch you guys in the next episode. Peace.